Here we are in part 3 of this short series, where I bring a sci-fi crate from Houdini to Substance and now to Unreal. With the bulk of the editing done, I know that it will be 5 parts in total. We already created the textures in Substance using the Udemy workflow and are now going over to Unreal. Here I already have the files from my previous tests, but we will bring these fresh in. There are some things to watch out for when it comes to importing stuff into Unreal. But this is the crate I exported and already used in that initial sequence. As you can see, it has only one material slot, and if I go into my material folder, there is a material instance called crate Udem. That I can just drag onto the mesh. Previously I didn't make use of the Udem tile mask. But now that I know how that works, let's get rid of this version of the crate. We make a new folder called test. And this might give you an idea how useful this might turn out later. Because I don't need to create a fully new material. I just create a new material instance of my Udem material. And this just says create Udem. In reality, I should name it just Udem, because I will be able to use this for each asset that was built in this way. But let's take this new material instance, add test to the name, and move it into the test folder. Before we follow it, let's take a look inside the material. And surprise, it's not a chaos of grabbing a dozen different textures. We only have the 3 texture maps we expect from Substance. It should be 4 in case we also integrate the emissive channel. In case you're not familiar with texture packing, this is why the template in Substance said packed. The 3rd texture holds the information for multiple channels. This default template packs ambient occlusion, roughness, and metallic into 1. Then here in the material builder, you can split that information again and feed it into the correct material attributes using the RBG channels. But in general, we only need these few texture samplers. But Substance just created 15 textures, the 3 maps and 5 UV tiles. So how does that fit together? The key is this small VT marker that you can see here in the corner. It identifies this texture as virtual. The sampler type of this texture is set to virtual color. That setting was chosen when I first dragged the texture from within Unreal into the original material. In my project, when I use the import menu, or if I pull up my file explorer where the textures are located, I can drag in the texture of any tile from one map, like base color for the tile 1001, and Unreal will recognize that this might be part of a Udem workflow and look for the matching texture files. So what ends up in Unreal is a virtual texture. If I open the texture, I can see here on the right that it actually included the source files of all 5 tiles. So this one texture asset. But Unreal won't do that by default. You need to activate this possible workflow in your project settings. Open the project settings and type in virtual. Here in the engine rendering section, there's a toggle that is off by default. Enable virtual texture support. Now, when you import a texture that is part of a tile set, Unreal immediately tries to import the whole set. You can see that by the VT marker in the corner of the texture asset. When I import the FBX file that I used for Substance, I make sure to not create any materials. I already have one. I can immediately use that FBX file in the scene, but to use the material, I need to swap out the textures in the material instance. My material instance has these textures as a possible parameter, because in my parent material, I didn't just use texture samplers, but param2d nodes. These are always available on the instances. With these 3 options tagged, I can drag and drop my textures in, save the instance, and then drag the material on the mesh. And this should match what we saw on Substance. Now that we know how to bring over textures, let's go over to the next step. The player is supposed to be able to place objects in the world, but they shouldn't just spawn directly. There should be something in place to make that transition look interesting. One way of doing that could be a material effect to materialize the object. This effect is done with this neat material using an opacity mask to reveal the mesh underneath. I found this along other interesting materials on the channel Unreal CG. The video link is in the description. It was meant as a dissolve effect, but since the effect is controlled by a parameter, you can just reverse the input values and you get a materialize effect. Besides the dissolving itself, there are of course the virtual textures that go into their respective channels. That way you get the mesh like it's supposed to look without the effect. When I go over to my blueprint for the crate, you find this material on the build meshes. So let's get rid of the previous mesh and drag in the skeleton version. This is what the blueprint will spawn during the building effect. Then we apply the material instance, called UDIM Dissolve, which is the material the blueprint has assigned during the transition. The transition itself is controlled by the parameter Dissolve Amount. So if I change that parameter while the mesh is in the scene, we should see how that creates the effect of the box dissolving, or materializing if reversed. The other parameters are there to fine-tune the effect itself, how wide the affected area is, how strong the emission is, and of course with what texture the affected area is displaced. This could be a flame texture, for example, or like in my case, a bit more complex pattern. After starting the project from scratch, I just took one of the pack textures from Substance. Even though it's not intended for that, it makes it look quite interesting due to its complexity. And this completes the relevant aspects of the UDIM workflow. In the next section, we are going to look at the C++ and the blueprint side of making the build and material transition happen. I see you next time.